Hello students, I'm Kokila here. Today you're going to have the computer session. This is your fourth lesson, Advanced Features of Word Processor, Part 2. So in your last week video, so Advanced Features of Word Processor Part 1 itself, we discussed almost lot of features of Word Processor MS Word. And here we are going to discuss the second part of MS Word's advanced features. Okay students, when you write a paragraph, listen carefully, okay, all of you. And this time also I'm going to show you the theory with some practical knowledge I'm going to teach you. So listen carefully. So you started typing a very lengthy many pages of paragraph something in your MS Word, okay, and now there is a mistake. One particular word whatever you used throughout the entire document, so that one particular word you have to find out where and all that particular word is located in your document. Do you think that is very easy? Yes, definitely. This option, if it would not be there, definitely that would be very tough. So here we are going to discuss how to find one particular word or one particular sentence or phrase whatever from the entire paragraph. And also if you are interested to replace that particular found word into a new word, means that is also possible very easily with the help of this MS Word. Okay, so now that is what we are going to do. So this is find and replacing one particular text. So how to do that finding and replacing option? So first let us see finding a text. So here already have typed in MS Word. This is MS Word, okay, white background, and I have typed some, this is just for making you understand, I just given some paragraph here. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to find one particular word, understand, called India. So India is a word I'm going to find out here in these three paragraphs. So where and all the word is located, so I have to understand. So first, how to find out that particular word? Here I'm going to home tab, okay, and coming to the complete last right hand side top corner, you can find that find option. So you just click this one. Here one navigation page will opens up. So I'm going to find out the word India. So enter. So here students, you can see here in our main paragraph, wherever there is a word called India, everything is highlighting in yellow in color. The background yellow color is highlighting our finding word. So I tried India here. So that word India is being highlighted here in the main document, that you can see clearly. So here, wherever there is a yellow color, that is all the word which I try to find out, understand. So this is very easiest way we can find out any kind of word like that. So for example, if I want to find out some other word also, for example, just simply two, T-O, so two word I'm trying to find out. You see where and all the word T-O-2 is given, you see only here. So these are the word. This is how we have to find out some words. Okay, some advanced level is also there, next to the find option, one more advanced option is there. So that is only called replace. So the same thing, home tab, and coming to the right side top corner, replace option, I'm clicking that one. So here one new dialog box is opening. So here you can see, so this is called find and replace. Here you can see the heading also. So I'm going to find out one particular word. So here you can see the heading, find what. So I'm going to find India. That India, while typing the word here, you have to type it without any spelling mistake. Okay. So I'm going to find out the word India in the entire document. And I do not want that particular word to be exist there. So I want to replace with one new word called Bharat. Okay. So all wherever there was a word India, everything will be replaced by one new word called Bharat. So here you can see the next some options called replace and replace all, find next something. So I'm going to replace all India. Wherever there was a word India, every place all that word should be replaced by the new word called Bharat. Okay. So now I'm going to give this option replace all. Okay. So students, you see what happened in the back. Here there was a India word and now it's changed to Bharat, and here it was India before, now changed to Bharat. So now you cannot find any word called India. Understand all of you. So this is what called find and replace option. I hope you understood. So now we will move on to the next heading. So replacing word text, that is what just we discussed. So now we will see the next heading called working with shapes. Okay, all the time whenever you're working with MS Word, sometimes you have to use some shapes also, inserting some shapes. It can be any kind of shape, like you can draw a anything or whatever you want, you can insert some shapes. So what to do, how to draw with, how to come up with some shapes. It can be any kind of shape. So I'm going to give you the example. So here I'm going to click insert option, insert tab, and there you can see an option called shape. Okay, so shape, just you click onto that, the down arrow symbol gives many shapes. So you see how many shapes varieties are there. So I can select anything. So just for an example, here there is smiley face. I'm just selecting the smiley face. That symbol changed to red plus symbol. So just clicking itself, come down, drag down. So the shape will show on the screen. So this is blue in color. If we do not want this color, just select on the picture. There you can see the shape styles. So here you click the down arrow. Here any color, whatever the color you are selecting, according to your selection, it will be changing. Understand? Yellow color I'm just selecting. And if I want to change some outline, different color, outline, red color I can give. So I'm going to give you some shadow, glow or whatever. So whatever you want, according to your selection, things will be changed. So one new smiley inserted. We didn't draw anything, but automatically the shape has been inserted with the help of insert and shape option. So you can select anything according to your wish. Okay, not only smiley, anything is possible. Done. So now we created one smiley shape. So now let us move to the next heading. This is what here in the book, working with shapes. So shape button from the insert tab, and these many shapes are there. So select which one you want. So accordingly you can make it happen in your screen. Okay, so this is what here in the book, they selected star symbol, and you can select any other colors to fill the color into the shape, and you can change anything. So placing text in the shape. So now I want to write some text. Text means some font letters that should exist inside the shape. So how to do that? So again, I'm going back to my smiley and I'm just clicking the picture, right click button, and here I can see text, add text option. I'm going to write something, anything I can write. Keep smile. keep smiling. So this is, if the wording is not clear, so I can change the color also, going to the home tab and change that particular color. I'm sorry. So I just changed the color. So now it will be big to see that. Okay. Smiley I have drawn before, and I added one text also. Okay. So you can write any text according to your wish. So now let us move on to the next heading, that is called working with drawing tools. So here the drawing tools are nothing but the same shapes option from the insert tab and line tool option. So you can create any of your own picture. So here how to open line tool and what to do. So here you can see one image like a mountain and clouds, and here there is one home. So student, I'm not here to draw anything. So I'm just giving you some hint how to do that. Wait. Okay, all of you see here, I'm going to the insert option, shape, I'm selecting a line tool, so I can just make a line. Okay, so anything, any kind of line I can make. So shape also, first I'm just anything according to your wish. So just a triangle, rectangle symbol, and shape triangle I'm selecting. So this is one small home. Okay, so anything, you can draw any of your favorite picture with the help of this line tool, just like that. Understand all of you? That's it. This is what called drawing tool with the help of line tool option from the shape tab. So here there is a task for you. So create a picture of a bus or car using the drawing tools. So if you're free, if you can, then follow these steps and try to draw a bus or a car. Okay students, and now let us see next heading called inserting word art. Word means font, and art means colors, shapes, and some shadow effect. So these kind of some artwork you are going to give to your word. So that is what called word art. So some here I'm reading out the definition. Word art is a text styling tool of MS Word that allows us to use special effects such as bending, twisting, shading, rotating. So this is from the gallery which styles can be selected. So how to do word art? So now let us see that also. So here I'm going back to the same thing. I'm just selecting this Bharat word. Okay, I just selected this one single word only. I'm going to and I'm selecting this insert tab. And you can see an option called word art here. Can you all see this one? Okay, so clicking the down arrow, and here you can see number of this A is nothing but just designs. Okay, different types of word art method is there. So which one you like, you can select it. So for example, if I select this one, according to that selection word, here that Bharat word changed. Okay, so all of you see, before it was simply just like that, and now it has been changed to the new like this. Fine. So can you see the Bharat is having some background color, some difference and all there. Understand all of you? So this is how we have to do the word art. For example, I'll give some more example. Just I'm selecting this one particular paragraph and again going to insert word art. Suppose if I change to something different, shadow effect, all of you see changed. So before something different and now wording is there, and in the down some shadow effect is also there. Okay, so this will be according to our word art selection, the wordings, fonts will be changed like that. So this is to make you understand even better. So I do not want that. I'm going back to the previous. Okay students, this is what called word art. So here also you can see in the book the same thing, word art, selection of different font, which one you want, you can select it accordingly. Fine. And now let us move on to the next heading. Inserting pictures. Okay students, in the in your document, only writing different types of paragraphs or inserting shapes, that is okay. But if you insert some picture, don't you think that looks so beautiful and pretty? Yes, definitely we can insert pictures also. So in two different method, one is from our computer itself. So you might have collected lot of pictures in your computer. So for one particular picture, if you want to insert in your document, that is possible with the help of this option called adding picture from computer. So now let us see that. So this is what our document, okay, and here in this first and second paragraph in between gap, I want one small picture to be inserted. Okay, so now I'm going to insert op tab, and here pay picture option I'm selecting, and anywhere wherever I want, which folder I have, accordingly I'm going there. For example, I want to insert one bike. Okay, so I'm selecting one bike and I'm putting insert. So see, one bike has been inserted. But if you want to resize your picture, that is also possible. So keep it anywhere wherever you want. Understand? So before there was nothing between the paragraphs, but here now I added one picture. So this is how you have to insert a picture. So this bike picture I inserted here from my computer gallery. I had this picture already in my computer, so I'm adding it here also. Suppose if you do not have any picture saved in your computer, so how come you can add a new picture? So that is also another option called insert. Before we use this picture option, but now let us see the clip art option. Click to the clip art option. Here the clip art one new window has been opened. So I'm selecting this is related, anything you can give, for example world. Okay, so world, go. So whatever the word I typed here related to this word, I will be getting some pictures here. Okay, so these pictures are already it was created when the software was created. Okay, so for this clip art you no need to get any internet or any connection. So this is already there within this MS Word itself. So which one related to the world searching word, I have received some pictures. Which one you want, you can select it accordingly. For example, if I'm selecting this one, that selection one will come here. If I want to increase the size, that is also possible. Okay, like that. So this picture I inserted here from my computer gallery, and the second picture I inserted through this clip art option. Okay students, so now let us see the next. After completion, just close this one. Okay, so now we will move on to the next heading. adding pictures from the computer, we just now saw that. And adding watermark. Watermark means it's a faded impression of a symbol, design, text or image on a paper. It is placed in the background of the text in a document. For example, students, how to insert a watermark? So you see, this is what your document page. So you see, I'm keeping the mobile very closely. Letters are there, pictures are there, but background only plain white color is there. So now I'm going to add something. Okay, how to add the watermark behind your document? So all of you go to this insert option, and there you can find this page layout option. You have to go page layout tab, and there you can see a watermark. So these are the ready-made one which is there already. I do not want these words to insert in my page. I want my own wordings. So here you can see custom watermark. So click on to custom watermark, and I want text wordings. I have to type the word which one I want actually. For example, computer. Computer word will display in the bag. Okay. So all of you, if I want, I can select the color also. Which kind of color? I'm selecting purple. Okay. Purple diagonally, which means cross, the word will be displaying. So apply. Close it. Students, can you see? Computer word has been written at the back of the document. If I delete this picture, you will understand even better. So this is what the before the computer word, it was not in the background, but now you can see the computer word, it is there in the backside. Suppose if I do not want, I want to delete this one, means definitely it's possible. Again clicking the watermark, and you can see remove watermark option. Remove it means the background, it's gone now. Fine. So the next one more option is there, that is called inserting picture watermark. So not only a wording, even a picture also it's possible. So selecting the same watermark option and custom watermark option, and now picture watermark, I have to select some particular picture. Now again I'm selecting the bike picture only. I'm going to insert. Okay, so I'm going to give apply or okay. So can you see the background is filled with the watermark, picture watermark? Bike is in the back side only. All of you understand. So this is how we have to insert picture watermark. If I do not want, just give remove, so that will be removed. Okay students, so this is called adding a watermark option. So we just saw inserting picture and also text watermarks. So now let us see the next heading called applying borders and shadings. Okay, so what is called borders and shading? If you create any document, you have to give the borders and shadings also. Then only that particular document looks pretty. So what to do for this? Just I'm selecting the entire thing. Okay, the whole paragraph, the entire document selected. And now I'm going to the home tab option. And here you can see font. Just click on to this. So here students, I just selected the all the entire page to give. I selected all, and after selecting the every document, I'm just going to the home tab, and I'm coming here to the paragraph, and here you can see the borders and shading option. Okay, so borders and shading option is here. Just click on to this, and here you can get, this is border tab. Okay, so this is border tab. If you want any border designs, you can give it. I'm just selecting 3D option. So you select it. And page border, if you want anything, so you can select it with the different styles. okay, and if you want any color, for example, I'm selecting a red color, so everybody can understand it easily. So thickness also I can increase even much better. Shadings, if I want, I can give. So some light color I'm going to give, light blue maybe. Okay, so I'm going to apply now. You see what is going to happen. Can you all understand the background color? I mean the line, it was not there, now line came. This is page border and this is the background color, light blue I selected. So now everything changed. So this is what border and shadings. Before it was just like this, okay, but now after changes it became like that. Fine. Okay students, and now let us see the last heading. We have one more last heading called inserting cover page. Cover page is nothing but whenever you are buying a new book, okay, the new book, whenever you are purchasing, the very front page, how does it look? Something attractive, something different picture. So that is what a cover page. So here, how to add a cover page? So that let us see. So this is what the document I created. So I want to give a cover page, the front page for this. So nothing, so just go to insert tab and the first option itself called cover pages. So lot of pictures are going to come one by one. So this is all a default one. Which one you want, you can select it accordingly. For example, if I select this one train is there. Okay, so this is what I have selected. This will be in the first page and the rest of the things, whatever we type, that will be in the next page. Okay, so cover page means the very front, the first front page is called cover page. If you don't like that one, so you remove the current cover page and you can give anything even much better, whatever you like. For example, this picture one, for sunflower picture. So this is what going to be my front cover page, and after that the remaining whatever the document I created, so that will be in the next. Okay, so now it will be a complete booklet. So that's all students, whatever I was telling you by showing this MS Word, that is what given here. You can see the picture. So this is called a cover page. So this is what advanced features of MS Word part 2, it's completed here. So as I said already, whoever is having computer or laptop at home, please do try everything practically. Unless and until you try practically something, you will not understand. So refer my video and go through this book and my video also. Don't waste time and learn it. Thank you.